ただいま。
あのね、今日は一緒に暮らしてから3ヶ月の記念日だよ。覚えてた？
もちろん。
So if you know anything about anime characters and virtual assistants, you've probably known that the Gatebox here has existed in one form or another since 2016. And it's more or less exactly what you expect. It's a holographic anime girl who serves as some sort of personal companion. You ask her questions, you can have conversations with her. It does sort of feel like more of an emotional kind of virtual assistant than a practical one. But there she is. She lives in this sort of half-glass too. What's really interesting is that an American company has actually decided, you know what? Let's take this idea and make it palatable to the Western world. Because millennials love anime, but not everyone's going to shell out $1,500 for a girl in a tube that only speaks Japanese. Now, as far as we've been able to gather, an American company in conjunction with a New Zealand developers worked on Hikari here and basically stripped out all of the innate cultural Japanese-ness and replaced it with a system that feels more palatable to Western customers. So, for example, we're hearing that they might be rolling these things out to a certain cruise line within the next couple months to act as onboard concierges that are available 24/7. They might also be used in gyms, for example, to check you in and maybe even help you out with some of your workout stuff. The hardware is a little bit different in this Western version. Instead of using this more elaborate projection technique, it's actually just a tablet inside of a chassis with sensors mounted right up top. It doesn't really look as good, but it does deliver the same experience, or at least that's what they're telling us. I haven't been able to talk to that thing because it's mute, it's loud, there's a lot of reasons why things don't work here. Now, I know what a lot of you are thinking. Walking up to this tube with a virtual girl inside it is weird. In this moment, in this place, in this country, yeah, it's a bit unusual. But it does have more significant appeal in Japan, where this aesthetic is widely appreciated. So yeah, there has historically been a tendency to look at devices like this and think, it's just this weird curiosity that's steeped in a very particular cultural mindset that doesn't really translate. And that might be true. I think I do actually know a person who bought one of these things. And I think he speaks to it despite not knowing any Japanese. So maybe there is room for this in our voice assistant driven world anyway. But it's more likely that you'll see this Western version available on a cruise ship near you. And who knows, maybe this will be the first step towards getting a mix of that Western sensibility and this Japanese style. And who knows, maybe it won't be long at all before voice assistants move out of the mainstream and we have more visual components like this to work with. It's a little bit different talking to a virtual human, but it is also in some ways a bit more comfortable, and that's always something to keep in mind. Ultimately, like I said, this has been around in some form or another for close to 4 years now, but it is really fascinating to see how people are starting to adapt it, take this fundamental technology, and work it up in a way that just feels more comfortable to more kinds of people. Anyway, thanks for watching, and stay tuned for more coverage from CES 2020 on Engadget.com.
今日も一日お疲れ様でした。二人でいっぱい思い出作ろうね。